Good morning, Vikings. Hope you're doing well. I'm Haley Lazar.
And I'm Jake Fulton.
Today's Friday, November 22nd, and welcome to VTV.
This week's top stories include a piece on gun violence.
Question of the week.
And finally, Messing with Faculty Part 2.
Now here's a serious piece on gun violence.
So Ms. Larson, what do you think about gun violence and laws and regulations in the United States?
Well, one of the aspects that I am focused on, of course, is violence in schools. And I feel very strongly, and we have a zero tolerance for any type of violence in school.
Beavers, what are your thoughts on gun violence?
I guess a couple main thoughts. One is the United States is a colonial settler society, so the country is built on violence. I mean, that's why we're here, because we took the land from the indigenous people. So you have to say part of this is just part of the kind of people we are, the kind of country we are.
Do you think bullying and mental disabilities have a factor in some of these shootings, perhaps?
I think everything has a factor. Those seem to be one of the targets. Bullying definitely escalates the situation.
Do you think gun control would make things better or worse?
Well, I think if people are angry and are reacting to emotional stress and, you know, real serious situations, and they have knives, then they can hurt more people than if they only have their fists. And I certainly think if they have guns or automatic weapons, they can hurt even more people. So I think the more restrictions we have, the less likely people can hurt masses of people.
I believe the government or parents or anybody could do anything about maybe stopping harms.
I think we all can. Down in Australia, they were having a lot, they had some shootings, and one of the things they did in the 90s was basically turn over all the weapons, and as a result, you can take a look at the statistics of what happened by a whole country taking a look at this, a close look at access to the weapons, and it basically just about wiped out these type of incidents. It's important that if any one of us knows of someone who's struggling, someone who needs to connect, that we let the administration or a teacher or a friend or somebody know.
Seriously, gun violence is a serious problem in today's society. So if you know any students who are struggling or are having problems, please tell them to go to the office and seek help in administration.
And now here's a piece on high school relationships.
What do you look for in a high school relationship?
I look for a lot of things in a high school relationship, like people who would care about me, someone I can have fun with.
Craziness.
Ryan Brown.
I took that picture.
Right there.
What do you look for in a high school relationship?
A girl with beautiful eyes.
I've been really trying to...
She has to like baseball, she can't play soccer, she has to be nice to people, she can't drive an Audi. Yeah, that's about it.
Loyalty.
Man's best friend.
Cuddly and soft.
Someone who achieves the ball in a timely manner.
That's basically my dog.
I look for someone with a sense of humor, kind of goofy, shorter than me. Mr. Wright, I'm coming for you.
What do you look for in a high school relationship?
Just someone like me.
Someone who's loyal to me.
Someone who's honest to me.
She has to have some hair, some eyes that work, two legs, two arms, 10 fingers, maybe 9.
Like no fights, no anything.
Well, first off, what I don't look for is a girl who says they like me, and this is they don't 2 days later, because that's just screwed up. But someone who's athletic, funny, smart, cool, fun to hang out with, goes like that.
Well, boys have cooties, so...
That is true.
So, Haley, what are you doing this weekend?
I'm with Aaron this weekend, actually.
Ooh. I wonder what Mr. Beavers would do.
Oh, hold on a second. I gotta take this, so hold on just a moment. Everybody, quiet down. Quiet down, everybody. Now, we all know Mr. Beavers is about to start his cell phone lesson. How about we mess with him a little bit?
Yeah.
Yeah! All right, guys, here's the plan.
All right, hey, sorry about that, you guys. You guys got the paper out then?
Yeah.
All right, cool. So let's title this lesson, let's see, let's call it cell phones. Cell phones and the philosophy of evil. So the first thing, if we're gonna understand this, we have to understand what information is. Okay. Now information is statements about the facts of the world. Okay, so it's statements about the facts of the world. Okay, so we get that down into statements about the facts. Okay, just statements about the facts of the world. Now,
is that a phone? Are you recording me? Give me that thing. No, put the phone in the box. Let's go. You know the rules in here.
All right, everybody, give me those phones. Let's go, put them in the box. If you don't, I'm afraid you might go to hell. So let's go, get them in the box. Get them in there, let's go. Those phones are evil. Hey, wait a minute, where's Jose and Ben? What? Oh my God, humanity is doomed.
Hey guys, it's Connor McKean. I got announcements for you from ASB. Coming up December 14th, we have the snow dance. You gotta wear white attire. Tickets are gonna be $20. Hope everyone can get out there and go. It's gonna be a fun dance. Hope to see everyone there. Thanks.
Thanks for watching VTV. If you have any questions, see Coleman in C7. Have a great day.
Deuces!